Hello, Reversi friends. My name is Art Beek, and I'm the author of Chess, Checkers, and Reversi for Android. Today, I want to talk a little bit about my Reversi for Android application, talk about its features, the options menu, the extended menu, etc. But I will also show how to connect Reversi for Android with an electronic board made by Certabo and play Reversi that way. The board is usually used for chess, but as I will show in this video, it can also be used to play Reversi using my app and this nice wooden board made by Certabo. First, let's talk a little bit about features of the application. So Reversi for Android provides an engine and a board play for the Reversi game. Regular play can be done by touching the screen for the next move. So to place a stone, the black stone here.
F5. F4.
I move that, the stones flip, and the computer has answered with the counter move. You see the notation here of the moves that are being made. If you want to see how that is, you can go to the option menu, which you open by this button on the right corner. And then you can enable the algebraic notation. And if you look careful, you see that it shows very tiny in the corners what fields are labeled in what way. Other features in the options menu are changing the strength of play or setting the computer to free play, where two humans can just play over the board, which is extra interesting when we start talking about the electronic board. I can also enable a move code which shows ghost stones where you can actually place the next move. So if you're new to Reversi and you're not exactly sure where you can place the next stone, this may be a useful feature to start learning the game. You can also enable key labels. And that is useful if the device has keyboard input and you don't want to type in on the screen all the time. There's more features. You can enable spoken moves. You can change the board gradient if you want to have a plain or a slightly lighted field. You can enable the piece animations if you don't want to have the flipping of the pieces but want to instantaneously see the other move, etc., etc. You can also change the board color. So let's do that. You can change it to blue, for example, light gray, brown, yellow. And then you see that it has slightly changed. Let me disable the gradient. You see it gives a more plain field. And you can undo moves. But there's also game navigation on the bottom. So look that we have already made two moves. Then I can just navigate through those two moves this way and go back with the other button. Or I can quickly jump back and forth that way. If I press the leftmost button, it actually takes back the last move. And now you see that it's actually White's move. So if I start playing now, I have taken over from the computer. And if I take one more back, it's the beginning position. To force play, use this one. And then the computer starts. You see the animation, and it's my turn.
G3.
So we have explored the options menu. There's also an extended menu, just like my chess and checkers app. To enter that one, long press the notation window, and it brings up three choices: copy the game, share the game, or connect to eboard. So sharing the game opens, for example, an Gmail app or potentially another Reversi app when it recognizes the format. But let's just copy the game. Then when I go to a mail app and I start composing and I paste, you see that I paste a notation format of the game. And I use something that is very close to PGN, but then for Reversi. And again, keep in mind that Reversi and chess use a little bit different, but similar notation by labeling the field slightly differently. Now let's talk about connecting Reversi for Android to a Certabo electronic board. So Certabo ships electronic boards that most people use for chess. That's why it's an 8x8 board. But instead of chess pieces, standard Certabo ships these chips that can be placed in the bottom of pieces and the board will recognize it, including Reversive for Android, will recognize the chips, and that's how the gameplay works. So most people take a chess piece, put the chips in the bottom, and for a full piece set, play that way. And Sertabo ships with 34 chips, and that is just enough for the both sides black and white, and two additional greens, which is a typical chess set. But in previous video, I've shown that you can also use this board for checkers. So if you 3D print checker pieces, and thanks to my brother-in-law for doing that for all these sets that you see here, I can, for example, make a king and a regular piece for white, place the pieces in the bottom, and that way 34 is still sufficient for like a full checker set and a couple of kings, and that helps you with regular play. However, for reversi, potentially in the end you can have 64 white pieces or 64 black pieces. So I will need 128 chips. And my friend Pietro from Sertabo kindly shipped me those chips so I can do this experiment. And what I did is, in a 3D printed set, I placed a chip in the bottom piece and at the top piece. And then I put a slight soft material in between, so there is a little bit distance. And the reason I did that, if the chips were too close, I got too much interference for when I flipped the pieces. So this way the board won't be interfering. Then, to play, the regular cable that comes with Sertabo ends with a regular USB-A. So I needed a USB-A to C connector and make sure that this is on-the-go compliant. Otherwise, it won't provide sufficient power from the phone to the board. Sertabo doesn't come with its external power source. Everything is powered this way. But sometimes cables look like this, but they're not OTG compliant, and you won't see any action happening on the board. Then I connect it to the phone, and you see all the lights go on because the connection has been established. But now I have to connect Reversi for Android with the board. To connect to the eboard, remember, long press the notation window to bring up the extended menu, then say connect to eboard. That brings up this dialog, and choose Sertabo USB and say connect. Then choose this USB one, allow Reversi to access the device, and now the connection has been established. No LEDs are shown, which means that the application has identified the chips on the board and matched them with the position. So the orientation in which they're placed on the board corresponds with the opening position, and it has recognized them. So if I would remove a piece now, you see that the LED goes on, showing that a piece is missing, and I can place it back and the LED goes off again. Now when I want to make a move, suppose I want to place a piece there, I have to make sure that the piece is in the right orientation, and I place it on the board. F5, D6. It has recognized the move. It also knows that I have to flip the position of this one, and the computer immediately has responded, so it already shows why it's response. So let me flip this piece to complete the move, place a white piece here for the computer counter move, and flip this piece to complete that. So let's continue the game a little bit so you get an idea. So if I place it here, then this one will flip.
C5.
I have to do that. The computer B6 is thinking. Responds with B6, and you see the move on the board. I have to place the white piece here to make it happen. The LED stays on, and I have to flip this piece to complete the reversing move. During the connection, you always see this green icon on the bottom. If it ever disappears or becomes red, it means the connection is lost, then you have to re-establish the connection. If you leave the pieces, you can just play from where you were. You can go to the options menu and choose free play. And now you can just make alternating moves on the board. So for example, let me place the next position for black here.
B2.
I have to swap it. And now the computer hasn't responded, but I can simply reply for white. D1. And make the moves on the board accordingly.
C1.
So as you can see, Sotabo provides a fun way to play the game of reversi on the board. But of course, the board could in principle be used for any 8x8 game. So I've shown chess, checkers and reversi. But with a 3D printed piece set and the chips that Sotabo ship, you could make a application for any other 8x8 board game and connect the board accordingly. Okay, that's it for today about reversi for Android and the Sotabo electronic board. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to learn more about particular features of the reversi app or about how to connect it to a Sotabo board, please drop a comment in the comment section or send me an email, and I'll be happy to talk about it in the next video. It was fun talking to you, and until next time, bye!